Forecasting is a form of machine learning that uses history data to predict what will happen in the future. Power BI provides us such forecasting feature with an easy use out-of-box option. This forecasting feature allows us to create the charts that predict future values based on the history data. It is only available for line charts with a date, time, or uniformly increased whole number values in the x-axis. Power BI uses exponential smoothing models to generate the forecast automatically, which means that not all data points in your history dataset are weighted the same. Instead, the more recent observations are deemed the most important, and the older the observation, the less they are used to calculate the future predictions. You can add a forecast by clicking on the Analytics tab and entering the arguments for forecast length, confidence interval, and the seasonality. You can also try Hindcasting to compare the forecast with the actual data. I shall explain this point later on. In this video, I shall demonstrate you the Power BI forecasting function with a simple sales sample data while going through all necessary steps and analytics configuration setup for creating an accurate forecast. First, we need to have the good quality time series data for the demo, which simply should have the enough longer history period on the time dimension, and little to none missing data. For example, looking at my Power BI desktop sample sales factor data in table, we have a revenue value since 1999 to 2014. It is longer enough history data. It also has a revenue value and the day level. In model view, we see the date dimension table that has the date hierarchies from year down to quarter, month, and day. Now let's have a quick view on the time series revenue data with a line chart based on few key forecasting data requirements, such as does it have a little to none missing data? Does it have a trend overall on increasing or decreasing? And does it have a seasonality in a year or in a quarter when we see a pattern that repeats itself every season? Place line chart in report pager. Drag and drop the revenue field into y-axis, date into x-axis. Data day level is too dense and x-axis. Let's remove it. Now we have an overview about the data. It has an increasing trend from the July 1999 to December 2008. After that, in 2009, the revenue dropped a lot. It gets a little step in 2010. Then go to increasing again till 2014. Also, in each year, it has the seasonality, which has high revenue in first quarter, then drop the volumes to the lowest level in June or July, then reach the highest revenue volumes in Q4. The month is November mostly. Thus, the data has two increasing trend periods from the 1999 to 2008 and the 2010 to 2014 with a seasonality. If we want to do some forecasting for the revenue of 2015, especially at the month level, the data somehow is good enough on its history date length, trend, and the seasonality. Based on the quick view, let's focus on the data from the period 2010 to the 2014 to do the forecasting. Expand the field panel. In field type, choose the advanced filtering. Show items when value is greater than 2009. Now we see the time series data has increasing trend with seasonality and now missing monthly data. To get the trend line, we move to the right panel, choose the tab, and further analysis to your visual. Switch on the trend line to draw a linear line. We see a clear trend as we expected. By this phase, we are somehow comfortable to apply Power BI forecasting feature for the data. Stay in the section and switch on the forecasting feature, expand the section. Assume that we want to forecast the revenue for 12 months in coming year 2015. Thus, let's place the length point to 12. Here, you can also use the list option months provided by Power BI. We shall use all history data from the 2010 to 2014, especially when we see the trend and the seasonalities of the data until the last month of the 2014. Thus, keep zero for the equal last point option. This equal last point option can be used to verify Power BI forecast model accuracies. I shall explain the point in the end of the demo. For seasonality option, we want to forecast the 12 month revenues as the seasonality pattern is existing in 1 year. We can also give our trust to Power BI forecast analysis and leave auto option for these options. The last option is a confidence interval, which means whenever we make predictions, the Power BI model will give a specific value as prediction, as well as a range of the values which the actual data may fall in with a confidence probability. This range is the interval, and the probability of confidence for actual data falls in this interval is so-called confidence interval. And here, let's place in 95% and click the Apply button. Now we see an extended session 9 with a gray range is generated for the last month 2014 to the December of the 2015. There are three generated values, forecast value, upper bound, and lower bound value for each month of 2015. With the forecasting, we have idea that with 95% confidence, the actual revenue of each month in 2014 will be falling in the forecast gray range. Come back to the equal last option. As mentioned before, we can try hindcasting to compare the forecast with the actual data, which means to change the value here, we may verify the accuracy of our Power BI forecast model. For example, if we give the 2 months to the equal last option, the Power BI will predict the revenue starts from the November of the 2014. Then we get the chance to compare the actual revenue of 2014 November and December with its forecasting data of these 2 months. With the option, we have some idea how the accuracy of the forecast model looks like. Of course, when we use the different history data, we will have the different forecast model. That is all about Power BI forecast demo from this video. Power BI provides us an easy use out-of-box forecasting feature, which allows us to predict future trends based on history data with exponential smoothing methods. It is one simple and powerful AI feature for us to make data-driven decisions and visualize the forecasted value alongside the history data in a customized chart. Thanks for your watching. If you like to watch more video from my channel, please press subscribe button. See you in next video.